Hi everyone. So in the previous class we discussed about electric field lines and properties of the electric field lines, and then we discussed about what is uniform electric field and what is non-uniform electric field. And now we are going to discuss about motion of the charged particle in a uniform electric field. So I mentioned already what is uniform and what is non-uniform. Uniform means the electric field will be same at any point, both in magnitude and direction. That means direction of the field is same as well as magnitude of the field is also same. Then it is said to be uniform electric field, right? And which diagrammatically we can represent the uniform field lines as by using equidistant and parallel lines. The lines must be equidistant from each other and they must be parallel. That means they must be in the same direction. So motion of charged particle in uniform electric field. In this we will discuss different cases here. Like the first case I am taking, when the particle is just released in an electric field. Suppose this is the electric field, uniform electric field is there in the region. Now a charged particle of charge Q is just released from rest. Its initial velocity is 0, right? So then what will happen? If you are placing a charged particle inside this electric field, what will happen? So we discussed already in our previous classes, if you are placing an electric field, charged particle in an electric field, a force of F is equal to EQ will act on the charge. And what's the direction of this force? So the direction of force will depend on this Q. If the Q is positive charge, then this force will be in the direction of this electric field, and if Q is negative charge, then that force will be opposite to the direction of this electric field. So that means on the positive charge, force will be in the direction of the field, and if the charge is negative, then that force will be opposite to the direction of this electric field. And so now here, we are taking it as a general case, that means positive charge I am assuming here, and so force acting on this will be along this direction, in the direction of this field. And so I can write this force acting on the particle as F is equal to EQ, and from this you can write acceleration of the particle. That means that now the particle, because of that force, the particle starts accelerating. We are taking that particle is placed on a smooth horizontal surface so that it is free to move. And so that acceleration of the particle we can write as F by M, and therefore this is EQ by M. So this will be the acceleration of the particle. And this acceleration value is a constant because the electric field is constant now. And so as the acceleration of the particle is constant, we can use our kinematic equations to find any other parameters. Like if you want to find velocity of the particle. Velocity at any time t. So then V is equal to U plus AT we can write. So in this case U is 0. So I can write AT. And so you can write this as EQ by M into T. This is the velocity as a function of time. And you can write displacement, you can write so displacement S is equal to UT plus half AT square. This equation we can use. And so that this equation we can write as half into EQ by M into T. So that is T square. So that is the displacement of the particle after time T. So like that we can do the remaining calculations. If they ask for example work done by this electric field, work done by the electric field means you can write this as change in kinetic energy you can write. You can calculate this velocity and you can write this change in kinetic energy you can write it. So work done by the field we can write it as, you may do it in two ways. we can write force into displacement. So this force is EQ into this displacement is nothing but half into EQ by M into T square. So you may write this as EQ whole square by 2M into T square. You may also solve this by using our work energy theorem. So write work energy theorem means, or you may also write this as work done is equal to change in kinetic energy moment. So that because here work is done by only electric field, we are taking that surface is a smooth horizontal surface, so that there is no effect of this gravity. Work done by the gravity and normal reaction will be zero, and so that only work is done by the electric field here. So half m into v square, the v square means you can substitute by using this EQ T by m whole square. So therefore you can write this as EQ into T whole square by 2m you can write. So this is nothing but same as that of this expression. So either you can solve by force into displacement method or you can solve by work energy theorem. So there is a work done by this electric field here. So that is a simple case when the particle is traveling, when the particle is released from rest in an uniform electric field. So mention this case when the particle is released from rest. This case what we are discussing here. So by that we can calculate. Now, if the particle is already projected with the velocity, if it is having some velocity, let us consider in the direction of electric field. If it is having velocity in the direction of electric field, simply the same calculation will be there. Then here u is not equal to 0. So here u term will be there, and similarly here also u term will be there. That initial velocity we need to consider. So that will be the only change in that equation is there. So just try to write that expression. So that is our graph. Case 2. When particle is projected right here, when particle is projected with some initial velocity, and taking that as for example V0, initial velocity V0, and we are taking that in the direction of electric field, let us consider there. That means this is the direction of electric field. Now this particle is projected here, it is projected with velocity V0, and again we are taking it as a positive charge, so we are taking the charge as a positive. Now it is projected like this. Now again, as it is a positive charge, we mention this, the force will be in the direction of electric field, and again we can mention the force on acceleration, the force acting on the particle, you can write this as EQ by M, where this EQ, and acceleration here we can write it as F by M. So you may mention this as EQ by M, and so as E is constant, and so still here also acceleration will be constant. So I can write velocity after time t so velocity after time t we can write as v is equal to u plus ad. That u is nothing but v naught you can write here. So v is equal to v naught plus a is nothing but eq by m into t. That is the velocity after certain time here. And similarly, displacement you may write. Displacement S is equal to V naught into T plus half AD square. A means directly I am substituting here EQ by M into D square. So this is our displacement. Now in this case also, if you want to write, the force EQ will be same. And the displacement means now we need to substitute this expression there simply. Write the formula also, work done by the electric field. Just instead of this, yes. Instead of taking this expression half a square, now V naught into T plus half a square you need to write. And even by if you want to calculate by using that kinetic energy method, this is our final kinetic energy. That means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy also we need to write. So that initial kinetic energy is also there, half m V naught square, and you may substitute. Either by solving this method or by solving this method, you will get the same answer. So just do the calculation. So that is the case when particle is projected with some velocity in the direction of the field. If you are projecting, for example, opposite the direction of the field, the same procedure you may follow, and simply you may substitute this initial velocity with the negative sign. You may take the vector notation, because if, initially the velocity will be supposed to be towards left, now the force will be towards right, and so initially it travels with some retardation. And so automatically at any instant you will get the velocity of displacement. If you are just applying the sign convention here, if it is particle is projected in backward direction, opposite the direction of electric field, then here you may take this as, you may substitute this as V naught as negative. So minus V naught plus AT you will get, and here also minus VT plus half AT square you will get. Just that is the difference when it is projected in the direction or opposite the direction means. Next, another important case is there when it is projected normally. When V bar is perpendicular to E bar, that means velocity of the particle is perpendicular to the electric field. Suppose say these are two metal plates. Between these two metal plates we are applying, that means there is some electric field here. Let us assume some uniform electric field is there here. Like you may consider these are the capacitor plates, which we will discuss later about the capacitor. So we can get the uniform fields between the two plates of the capacitor. And this length of this each plate, the dimension of this plate is L I am making here. And now here exactly at the midpoint we are projecting a particle here. Let us say it is projected with initial velocity u, this is a positive charge q. That means we are projecting the particle horizontally with the velocity v, and here neglect the gravity. Gravity is neglected here. So gravity is neglected. So now the particle is projected horizontal, which is normal to the direction of electric field. These arrows is nothing but direction of electric field here, which is in downward direction. And so now you can easily analyze the motion. That means now it is like a two-dimensional motion. That means exactly I can say that it is similar to that of our horizontal projectile in kinematics. In kinematics, we know when the body is projected horizontally from the top of the tower, then one force will be there in downward direction, which is nothing but gravity, right? Now here similar to that, this electric field will, force will be there, force due to electric field, which is acting in downward direction. And so that similar to the kinematics projectile, horizontal projectile, so here it will follow some parabolic path. And there is no force in horizontal direction, so the horizontal component of velocity will remain same. And only there will be change in velocity in vertical direction. So let us write those equations and you will get the clarity about it. So instead of traveling along this path, it will follow some curved path like this. So this is the displacement along this y direction finally when it comes out here. And so just I am writing this force along xi direction is 0. That implies acceleration along x direction is 0. And so velocity along x direction at any instant is equal to initial velocity u, which is a constant value. And therefore displacement along x direction is nothing but, you can write this as velocity into time. So displacement along x direction at any instant I can write this as vx into, that means u into t. Suppose let us say it is taking a time t naught to travel this to completely come out of this plate here. That means to completely come out of this region. Then you can write this as L is equal to u into t naught. You can write here. That means then it travels a total distance here in a time of t naught. This is at any instant we are taking. This is general equation, and this is to come out of this region. We are taking the time taken as t naught. Now similarly, this is totally along x direction here. These equations are. Now similarly, you write the corresponding equations along y axis. So along y axis, if I write, then you can write this force acting along this y direction will be equal to E cube. This electrostatic force. This is a positive charge. This positive charge, this field intensity is E, then force acting on this positive charge will be in the direction of electric field. So that is along this negative y direction you will get. That means here you should remember in electric field that whatever may be the direction of velocity of the particle, the force direction has only two possibilities. That is, if charge is positive, the force will be in the direction of field. If charge is negative, then force will be opposite the direction of electric field. So this direction does not depend whether the particle is at rest or whether it is moving. If it is moving, whether it is moving in the direction of field or opposite to the direction of field or perpendicular to the direction of field, it doesn't depend on these factors. So only you need to identify initially if it is positive, then force will be in the direction of field. If it is negative, then it is opposite to the direction of field. Only you need to remember that point. So here the charge is positive, so it will be in the direction of field. That means downward direction you will get. Then acceleration of the particle E q by m. And so you can write again this acceleration is constant there. So you may write this velocity at any instant if you want to write initial velocity is 0 plus ay into t you can write. Therefore velocity at any instant you can write this as E q by m into t. Then displacement along y axis. So displacement I can write as Sy is equal to initial velocity along y axis 0 because particle is projected horizontally. So 0 plus half. Here it is positive y axis. We are taking in upward direction. So you may consider this is in a downward direction. Otherwise you need to take some negative signs here. So for simplicity, I am taking this as in downward direction as our positive y axis. So you can directly take that as positive signs here. Otherwise, you will get the negative signs here. You need to represent rhetorically. If you are representing, you should represent with the negative sign. So here I am taking this downward direction as our negative y directions there. So then I can write half a t square. A is nothing but eq by m into t square. That means to say this path is parabolic path, you may use this equation. You may substitute this t value here. Therefore, y is equal to the displacement along y axis, nothing but y I am taking here. So that y is equal to half eq by m into t square. The t is nothing but you can write this as x by u whole square. So this is eq by 2m u square into x square. So this is nothing but our parabolic equations here. That means from that we can conclude that the path followed by the projectile is parabola. And now here, generally they may ask sometimes one more question here. What will be the displacement of the particle along y direction when the particle comes out of the field? When the particle comes out of the field means this distance we need to calculate here. Suppose this Sy we are taking here. So that means I am taking this as some d, the deviation of the particle. So let us write the deviation expression now. There will be questions based on this. So when the particle comes out of that, they simply can substitute that value here. When particle comes out of field, that is x is equal to L, you can write in this equation. This displacement should be equal to L. Therefore, this D is equal to, I can write this as EQ by 2 mu square into L square, you can write here. So, this is our equation now. And in this, sometimes they may give the different conditions, like two particles they may give. Two particles, like one is alpha particle and other is proton, they are traveling like this. Now they will ask the deviations, that means that the ratio of this D value they will ask. The ratio of D value is nothing but you can take this ratios as depending on the given condition. Like they mentioned, initially they are projected with same velocity, and initially they are projected with same momentum, or initially they are projected with same kinetic energy. Such a conditions they will do. So I will mention those conditions now. If two particles are projected, with same speed, that means now the same speed means in this equation now u will be same. So u is same is, now we can write this ratio as d is directly proportional to q by m, you can write. So this is a proportionality for this. Right? If particle electric field is same, they are traveling in the same electric field only. And this L is also same. We are taking the identical conditions. Two particles are projected in the similar region. And next, if they are projected with same momentum, same initial momentum, so if they are projected with same initial momentum, now see this, you need to do the small modification here. EQ by 2, here I am multiplying with m, so mu whole square into L square you can write. And therefore now this is the momentum, so which is a constant value. Therefore I can write this equation as d is directly proportional to q into m. So if the speed is same, then q by m, d is proportional to q by m you will get. If that momentum is same, then this mu value will be constant and d is proportional to q into m. And sometimes if I mention the condition, like if they are projected with the same kinetic energy. So now I will mention here, so if they project with same initial kinetic energy, now we can write this as d is equal to e cube by, now this value we need to write in terms of kinetic energy, so then I can write this as 2 into ke into L square, or let it be ke naught, initial kinetic energy, because our half mu square is our kinetic energy, so from this mu square you can write as 2 times initial kinetic energy. And therefore, I can write this as d is equal to EQ by 4 into initial kinetic energy into L square. And therefore, this is, if two particles are projected, then this is Q by E naught, that means K E naught we can write here. So, that will be the dependence there. So, like that, they may ask the ratios for the two particles by giving certain conditions. So, if speed is same, we need to use that condition. If this momentum is same, then we need to use this condition, d is proportional to q into m. If this kinetic energy is same, then we need to use this condition here. That is the deflection of this particle when it comes out of this field, electric field. And the path followed is parabola. Next, you see this effect of electric field on time period of a single pendulum. So the effect of time, electric field on the time period of a single pendulum. So in actually in simple harmonic motion topic, we discussed like when the pendulum is accelerating, when the point of suspension is accelerating, there we mentioned one simple formula there. 2 pi into under root of L by this net acceleration or effective acceleration we need to write here. When the point of suspension is accelerating, like if it is suspended in a lift and if lift is moving upwards, then we need to write it as g plus a, the effective acceleration. When lift is coming down, we mention it as g minus a. So like that, if by using such a simple technique, you can answer here also easily. So the first case I am taking like so this bob is carrying some charge here, say positive charge Q, and now the electric field is uniform electric field is acting in this region like this, particularly downwards. And this bob is remaining, it is having this mass m and this length of the pendulum is say L, or remaining conditions are same. So just we are taking this, this bob is carrying some charge Q, and here this E is electric field, it is suspended, it is totally oscillating in a space where the uniform electric field is there downwards. And so now here, due to gravity, one force will be there, and due to this, another acceleration will be there. That means another force will be there, EQ will be there in downward direction here. So already MG is there, and additional EQ will be there. Therefore, I can write this net acceleration in this case as G plus EQ by M. So already G is there, now additionally the EQ by M will be there in the same direction as that of gravity. And so these are net accelerations, you can directly substitute this net acceleration in this formula. Therefore, I can write this time period as 2 pi into under root of L by G plus EQ by M. So in this type of problems, you should answer it carefully by reading the question, by reading the given data. Like here, if it is mentioned like negative charge in the same problem, then force acting on this negative charge will be opposite the direction of this electric field. So the force will be in upward direction. When force is in upward direction, then here you will get G minus EQ by M you will get. So that you should identify here. And similarly in the same case, let us consider if force is in upward direction, let us consider now. Field. When the field is in upward direction, for example, see if the electric field is there like this and this Q, M. Now similarly we can write this, now the force due to this electric field EQ will be along this direction and MG will be along this direction. Therefore I can write this net acceleration as G minus EQ by M. And directly I am substituting there, therefore this time period is 2 pi into under root of L by G minus EQ by M you can write here. That is a time period expression. Now similarly in the same case, if the charge is negative charge, then force due to electric field will be in downward direction, then you will get G plus EQ by M you will get here, similar to that. So that means you need to identify the direction of this force depending on direction of the field and whether it is positive or negative charges. And next here, the next possibility is, suppose the field is acting horizontally. So there is a uniform electric field along this horizontal direction. Now the bob is carrying some charge Q. Now the force due to this electric field EQ will be along this direction and the gravitational force MG will be there along this direction. Therefore you may write this net acceleration, I am directly writing here, under root of G square plus the acceleration due to this will be EQ by M. So EQ by M whole square. Therefore I can write this as T is equal to 2 pi into under root of L by this A. So here it is G square by EQ by M whole square. So here again under root is there, should be absorbed. So that is the case when field is accelerating and field is acting horizontally. And the next possible I am taking here. Say some charge Q is there. Q is given to this bomb. And an identical charge Q is placed in the point of suspension. So that here there is any additional field. One Q is placed at the point of suspension and an identical charge is given to this bomb. And so now we need to answer how the time period changes or what will be the time period. If initial time period is T naught, for example, then what will be the time period? So in this case, what you can observe is there any change in time period? Is the time period increase or decrease? If you are placing a one point charge at the point of suspension and another charge is identical charge is given to this bomb, is there any change in time period? That means is the time period increase or decrease or remain same? Further, simply consider, is there any change in restoring force or not? If there is any change in restoring force, then you may consider the time period may change. If the restoring force remains constant, then there is no change in time period. Suppose if I consider here, if the bomb is if you are taking in this position, now the forces acting on this bomb are tension, mg, and this electrostatic repulsive force between these two will be along this direction, eq. If we resolve this mg into components, for example, this angle is theta, then this mg cos theta and this will be mg sin theta. And so now in this the restoring force is still mg sin theta. Even if these charges are not there, no charge is given to this bob and no charge is placed at the point of suspension, then also the restoring force will be mg sin theta only. Even when you are placing the charges, then also time period will be mg sin theta only. So from that what we can conclude is time period in this case doesn't change. If one charge is placed at the point of suspension and another charge is given to this bomb, so time period T is equal to T dash is equal to T, you can write. That means time period remains same. So time period remains same. That means due to the presence of those two charges, the time period doesn't affect. So those are the some cases of this simple pendulum and how this electric field affects the time period of this simple pendulum. And one more application is there, like the effect of this electric field in case of an oblique projectile. So oblique projectile, in uniform electric field. So electric field, uniform electric field. So we know all the principles of the oblique projectile. Like suppose say here a body is projected with some initial velocity u at an angle theta with this. And here I am taking this electric field is in downward direction. Uniform electric field is there in downward direction I am taking here. And this charge is a positive charge. The charge particle is a positive charge I am taking here. And here there are two possibilities of there. That means two cases we can consider here. One is in the presence of gravity and electric field. The other one is gravity is neglected and only electric field we need to consider here. And so now here I am taking a case like both are present. If simply in that if both are present, you will get some expressions. So in that if gravity is absent, then you may simply substitute the g value as 0. Then you will get in the absence of gravity expressions. So here mg is there in normal direction and eq is also there in normal direction. So simply what we can write is The effective acceleration along y direction is minus of g plus eq by m. So this is the only effect of this electric field. That means in addition to the gravity, it produces an acceleration of eq by m in the same direction. If the electric field is given in downward direction and if this charge is a positive charge, if this charged particle carries a positive charge, then this will be the case here. You can write all the expressions, and wherever you are getting the g in our expressions, then instead of g, you need to write simply g plus eq by m. So for example, if I write time period, time of light, so a general time of light expression is, so general time of light expression is 2 into u sin theta by g we need to write. So which you can write is 2 into uy by ay, or modulus of ay actually this is. That means the 2 into y component of velocity by modulus of y component of acceleration. So similarly now we can substitute here. 2 into y component of velocity will be same u sin theta by y component of acceleration will be g plus eq by m. So this is our time of light here. And then next we will write maximum height. So h maximum you can write this as similar to this. Our general formula is h maximum is equal to u square sin square theta by 2g. So which we may mention it as 2 uy y component square by 2 into mod of ay. So just I am writing here u sin theta, that means u square sin square theta by 2 into g plus eq by m. So it is the maximum height. And similarly we may write the range. Range expression. So range is equal to horizontal range. Our formula is u square sin 2 theta by g. Or you can write horizontal component of velocity into time of flight, you may write. Or horizontal component of velocity is nothing but u cos theta into this time of flight, you may write here. So I can mention this as, that means this is a general formula. This is a general formula. So I will write here a general formula. U square sin 2 theta by g. And so here we can mention this as u square sin 2 theta by, just instead of g, we need to write here effective acceleration. G plus eq by m. So these are the changes taking place here. So simply you can remember that. In our standard expressions, wherever g is there, so instead of that g, we need to write the effective acceleration. So that is g plus eq by m. So in this, sometimes if it is mentioned that gravity is neglected, if gravity is neglected, then you can write this, so simply this g value can substitute it as 0. If g value is substituted as 0, then automatically you will get the expression in the absence of the gravity here. So then basing on that you can observe that, or sometimes you won't mention any condition whether gravity is present or gravity is absent. So then automatically this eq by m value is very large when compared to that of g, then you may neglect that value. So then basing on that comparison we need to consider here. So with the help of these expressions or this discussion, you can solve almost all the problems based on this uniform electric field due to the point charge. And most of the charged particle in uniform electric field, whether it is time period related questions or whether it is questions related to this projectile motion, or whether it is motion of charged particle through the uniform electric field in the direction of motion, in the direction of electric field, or perpendicular to the direction of electric field, you can solve almost all the problems based on that. And in the next classes I will discuss the problems based on the electric field produced by the continuous standard distribution. So up to now we are discussing the problems based on this, or the concepts based on the point charge, electric field produced by the point charges. So in the next classes we will discuss the expression for the electric field due to the continuous standard distribution, like a line of charge or a ring or a disk or a plane of charge. We will discuss those concepts there. And now with this class, you can complete the problems based on electric field until the level 3. That means motion of charged particle in uniform electric field, all these applications like time period applications, all these projectile motion applications. You can complete electric field problems based on electric field. You can complete up to level 3, level 1, level 2 and level 3. So those 3 levels you can complete. And level 4 and level 5 problems you can solve after the completion of this continuous class distribution. So that will start tomorrow. Thank you.